It's Wolfie-chan, and I'm back with another manga review, and this one is House of the Sun. And I've read up to the fifth volume, which there feels like there's going to be more, but it's not out yet. So I've read up until that point, so I'm basically caught up on the story, as much as I can be. And this is just an amazing kind of story that I myself think is just... It's so sweet, but also really sad. So you start off with our little kids in this big house with this big family that basically are there and are so happy. And they're basically kind of fostering this little girl who her parents are never at home, her mom's never there, and her dad's never there. And you find out in the story why all of that happened. But I'm not going to do spoilers until the end of the series and do my final thoughts on it. But there's a little girl, and she just wants to be called Mao, because I believe that's actually her name. And one of the boys calls her Malgyo? I think so. I can't remember it. I can remember. I don't know how to say it. And so she's always underneath the shrine, just kind of hiding and not wanting to be around an empty house and all that good stuff. Well, you find out that her family is going to get divorced. And that's, as a little girl, like 5 years old, your family's going to get divorced. And your mom brings home this random dude and says, he's going to be your dad soon. Yeah. Like, I'm not for the mom. And the dad, I feel for him, but in a way that, like, really, really kind of feel. So, what happens is that she grows up, and she picks her dad, because she thought, you know, this is the person that I always felt was, like, awesome. But she picks her dad, and still feels alienated in his family. He gets a new wife, she has a little girl, and she feels for Mao, and wants her to be kind of part of the family, and this is a high school girl at this point. And she doesn't feel like she's in the family. She doesn't feel part of the family. And it's sad because I know how that feels. I know how it feels when you're just kind of there. And you don't feel like it's a family. You just feel like it's a hodgepodge of whatever happens. So it's really, really sad. And she is out late talking to Hiro, which is the family. And what happened with his family is that his parents died, and his siblings kind of got taken in by different siblings, and he stayed in the house, he got a job, he took care of the house, and all that stuff, because that house was built by his father to make a very happy life, which is so sad. And Hiro sees her underneath the shrine once again, and basically sees her eating convenient food, and she's not really happy about it. It's what she could get because she stayed out and was talking with Hiro. And when she got home, they were like, oh, we already ate. We thought because you were so late, you probably ate already. When in retrospect, no, she really didn't. And that's a horrible assumption for people. Just, you were out late, so you probably already ate. What if I was out late just talking with somebody and then I walked home alone? And I didn't eat anything. Like, they didn't even ask, like, are you hungry? No, it was more the dad assuming it, which is really sad. And she sees that her chair that she always sat in was taken over by a little girl. And I understand that as well. Like, people are sitting in the spots that you and your family used to kind of have. So it's just like, well, I don't feel close anymore. So, it is very sad, and it is a very touching kind of first couple. And then when you find out that Hiro basically goes, if you don't want to be with them, and you feel like you're alienated, why don't you just come live with me? And so she does, but she kind of slowly finds out that she has feelings for him. And all throughout this book, she's also writing an online novel, which I want to see if that's really real. Oh, it's so cool, and I'd actually love if, like, people did that, like, there was an actual website like that, but I haven't delved deep into the internet that much. I've, like, been on DeviantArt and like people do it from there. But I don't know. But she's in that, and you find out that Hiro is really interested in her story, but she doesn't want to tell Hiro that this is her story. So she kind of keeps it under wraps. She writes, she finds another person that Hiro works with that's a girl who loves her story as well, and they meet up and hang out and kind of bond until she finds out that she likes Hiro, and she, Mao, likes Hiro. So it's a conflict of interest and all that stuff. And she's trying to write, but she's trying to live her life. And trying to be just in the moment. And she admits the first time that she likes Hiro. But Hiro kind of is, like, over the head with it. Like, he doesn't get it. He doesn't understand. He's just kind of, like, meh about it. Which is really sad. And, like, the next day after that, she says, well, it was a joke. I just want to see you react. And he's like, oh, why'd you do that? I wouldn't, like, it was so hard because I didn't know how to talk to you about this or how to do that. But she really does have feelings for him. And it's so sad because when you get closer and closer to the fifth volume and you see her and even, like, that family with Hiro and he gets his brother, which is Dayaki? I think it's Dayaki. And he's, like, not into them, like, her living with Hiro. But then he's like, okay, she has no place to go. And, like, the saddest point in all these manga is that the dad just was like, yeah, just let her live with you and I'll pay rent. And so, one time in the book, she actually goes, and this is, like, I think the fourth or fifth one, she goes and tries to tell her dad that she does want to come home, that she does want to be part of the family, and he just kind of gives her money and is like, you know, if you want to be independent, you should probably get a job and start paying for yourself. I won't pay for you forever. And that's, like, a jab that she's like, this is all on assumptions. And everything that happened in his life, I get why he's that way. But it's your daughter, for goodness sakes. So she just takes the money and walks away. And Hiro's been very passive-aggressively mad at him. Like, and basically, she then runs into her stepmom and kind of runs off. And Hiro talks with her, and Hiro's like, yeah, she does really want to come back. It's just she doesn't know how to let out her emotions and talk about it more. So she's basically kind of in this little bubble where she doesn't know how to say anything or even that or express her emotions. So definitely keep trying to bring her home, because that's what Hiro wants. He wants her to have a family. And Mao is kind of like, I just want to live by myself. And I haven't, like, after the first manga, you don't see the mom anymore. Like, she's just disappeared. And that bugged me a little bit. But it bugs me more with the dad that's just like, here's the money, whatever. That really, really bugs me. You just see her trying to deal with all this stuff. She does get, like, a part-time job with Dakai. And they're both in this era restaurant and all this stuff. And she basically tells the person that likes her writing, don't come over there anymore because I'm working there and I don't want Hiro to find out that I'm working there. And then she tells her that she likes Hiro as well. The friendship kind of meh. Which then there's another arc where this boy at school likes her and he wants to date her and she just doesn't feel that way. Which you can't blame because it is high school. But this is an amazing story. And with every little story parts into this culminating in this main story, this is amazing. I swear I just love this manga, and I can't wait for the next one. I wanted to, like, keep reading it, but when I found out I had read to the max, I was like, well, that's good. So, if you like this video, definitely leave a like. Leave it in the comment section below. Have you read it? Have you heard of this manga? And who's your favorite character? Mine right now actually has to be Hiro, because he's so strong. and just wants to help her and wants to be a part of this and really wants Mao to be the person that she wants to be. And because she still has a family, he wants her to still be with the family, unlike him, whose mother and father both died. So I'm really a hero fan. And definitely subscribe because I do upload every day, and I've been trying to upload at a certain time every day. So I'm sorry. But I do upload either new anime, new manga, something new, something old, something different, or a movie. And I upload every day. For any day you just don't feel like it, I'm there with a video for you. And I do hope that you've been having a very wonderful, wonderful day. It rained pretty hard, and I'm hoping that it'll still rain. If you also want to follow me on Twitter or Facebook for more interactions, definitely there are links down below. Wolfie Chow out. Bye, guys.